12:22.
That was pick 21. Yes.
The process that we had before the biometric clock was people would sign a timesheet, so each individual, and we can have up to 400 extra hires here on one day. And say 100 or more would clock in at the same time. You can imagine the chaos with people writing their names on their timesheets. And then when they left at night, it was even more chaotic. Instead of standing in line waiting for someone to find their timesheets, they literally just wait to put their finger in the clock. It reads the capillaries in people's fingers.
So when they come in for the shift, they click, they hit the check-in, insert their finger in the machine, and it recognized my fingerprint and checked me in for my shift.
So we can run about 20 people through a minute, which is huge and fast.
Before, it took me about 10 hours to do payroll from the time I started entering everyone's payroll off the timesheets to the time I proofed them and approved them. Now it takes me approximately 45 minutes.
It saves her a ton of time in workday processing this time because it's automated and it's more accurate.
The extra hires just, they went with the flow and they're using it like it's been here for years. Julie Colacurcio has done a great job of setting them up, training them for this. It doesn't take very long to set them up, but once they're set up, it's just smooth. They love it.
If somebody has a problem clocking in, then I go out and help them make sure that the fingerprints are working, re-register another finger.
We went through a lot of testing, a lot of setup, a lot of people working real hard, and a lot of extra eyes being patient with us as we tested several clocks and got the settings exactly right.
That $10,300 investment is easily cost effective and purchased back. We estimated $9,500 of what we'll be saving, and it probably will be more because the general presidential is so large, and then it also has become something that's so successful we'll be able to do across the county.